Hello, welcome to my channel. This is Dr. Rowe, the blood lady, the starch lady, and those are .coms if you need to go look at more information. But look what I have here. I've got a lovely pot of split pea soup. Oh my gosh, this is an entire pound of split peas, the entire bag. And I'm just going to go in here with my submersion blender and we're going to mush this up a little bit, and then you're going to be really surprised. We're going to use this for our starch today, and I want to trick my husband. I know he's going to watch this video at some point, but I'm going to wait until after he eats dinner to be able to see it. I've done this before, and he just doesn't know it, but we're going to turn this starchy split pea soup, which is full of fiber. Did you know there's 11 grams of fiber in a serving of split pea soup? That's amazing. But we're gonna cream this up, and then we're gonna do a little trick, and I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna stick in here to make it even more healthy and be qualified for more than a 50-50, more like a 75-25 ratio. All right, starches to vegetables. Might get a little noisy, but I love this submersion blender. But look how fast that just kind of blends it all up. Lots of water there. Sometimes we like our soup a little bit thicker, so sometimes I might even add, if it's still too thick when I get done, I might even throw in some of my cooked potatoes that I have up in the fridge that are chilled. I cooked them in the Crockpot yesterday. Me and my Crockpot are friends. I love the submersion blender because you can do this when the food is hot, where you can't do that in a regular blender. The lid would pop right off. Okay, now let's see how that turned out. Oh yeah, that's just super, super creamy. It's kind of thin, so I put a little bit more water. Usually you do 2 quarts of water to a pound of beans, and I put a little bit more. This is a 6-quart container, so I probably doubled that. There's probably 4 quarts in here, a full gallon, but you'll see why here in a minute. So here's the pound of split peas that I used yesterday. Now this one, I notice it only has 7 grams of fiber, whereas I have used another brand in the past that was 11. So just kind of read your labels and see what your sources provide for that on that. But this is what we're going to add to it. You ready for this? Oh my goodness. We've got an entire onion, a whole bunch of fresh cut green beans. That's an entire zucchini, excuse me, not zucchini, cucumber. And if anybody of you know me and have had your microscopic blood done with me, you know that I love cucumbers. They are one of the most alkalizing foods on the planet, next to a black radish, which is extremely bitter and hard to find. But a cucumber is so alkalizing. Your body converts that to a beautiful, perfectly balanced alkaline to buffer some of the things that are in our diet. All these foods are good, but cucumbers are my favorite for buffering acidic foods. Got an entire yellow squash. We got an entire zucchini. Got an entire box of baby spinach. And you'll see that I've got my little baby blankets in here, keeping it all layered and fresh and stuff so that it doesn't get all moist. This is actually from payday last, so it's at least 2 weeks old, or getting right at 2 weeks old. And then we've got an entire bag of the organic broccoli slaw. And yes, all of this is going to get blended up with some of that runnier split pea soup you just saw over there. And I'm going to blend it up and then put it back into that soup. So if you were to take this pound of beans and you compare it, you know, size-wise, I guess, you know, to this amount of vegetables and stuff that's going on here, we've got definitely more than 50%, closer to 75% vegetables to our split pea ratio. So this is going to be one of those soups that you can just have and enjoy anytime on the Starch Solution Whole Food Plant-Based program.